Are you looking for an ultra low-cost, no-nonsense way to record your Mac computer screen? Well, if you have a relatively modern Mac, you already have a great little screen recording application already loaded onto your machine. It's called QuickTime Player. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use QuickTime Player to create great quality screen recordings. Coming up. Hey, it's Mike with more tips and tools to help you create engaging, informative, and educational video. And if it's your first time here, welcome. And make sure you hit that big subscribe button and don't forget to click the little bell icon so you don't miss a thing. QuickTime Player is an often overlooked media creation tool that comes pre-installed on a Mac. You can use QuickTime Player to record audio, record and edit video. You can also use QuickTime Player to record your computer screen to create great quality screencasts. Let's hop onto the computer so I can show you the process. So here we are on my Mac. I'm running Mac OS 10.13.2. And I have this Keynote project open here. Now let's say I want to record a tutorial using this Keynote project. Well, obviously, in order to do that, I need to record my screen. And to do that, I'm going to use QuickTime Player. So to launch QuickTime Player, I'm actually going to go up to this magnifying glass icon here, which is Spotlight Search. Open that up, and I get this search field. And I'll start typing in QuickTime. And there's QuickTime Player. I'll double-click that to launch it. You can also find QuickTime Player in your Applications folder. Okay, now I'll go up to the top menu bar. And making sure QuickTime Player is active, I'm going to select File, New Screen Recording. You can see there's also a keyboard shortcut for that. Now, when you select New Screen Recording, you get this little screen recording interface. This red circular button is what you select to start recording. But before we do that, we need to set a few options. Now, when you click this little down arrow beside the record button, you'll get options for your screen recording. The first option is microphone. So any microphones you have connected to your computer will be listed, including the built-in or internal microphone on your Mac, which you could use to record your voice for your screen recording. I prefer to use a higher quality external microphone, which in my case is the Rode NT-USB microphone, which I have selected and I'm using right now. Now, most likely you're going to have to adjust the level of your microphone. To adjust the microphone level, just go up to the Apple icon here and select System Preferences, select Sound, select the Input button, and then select your microphone in the list. Here is mine, the NT-USB microphone. And then down here beside input volume, you can use this slider here to adjust the input level of your microphone. This meter down here shows you your microphone level while you speak into the microphone. You can see it moving up and down as I speak right now. You want to adjust your input level so that the meter kind of peaks around this second to last little dot here. You don't want it sitting in this last dot consistently. Usually, if that's the case, your level is too hot and your sound could be distorted, which isn't very good. Okay, now that our microphone level is set up, I'm going to close out of the sound panel here and return to our screen recording interface. I'm going to open up the options menu again by clicking this downward arrow. And down here you can see options. You have the option to show mouse clicks in your recording. So everywhere you click on the screen during recording, a little circle graphic will flash onto the screen, helping draw the viewer's attention to that spot where you clicked. I'm going to leave this unselected for our demonstration. Now, this slider control here allows you to listen to your voice through your speakers or headphones if you have them attached to your computer as you record. a bit of a warning here. There is a delay between when you speak and when it comes out of the speakers, which can be incredibly distracting. I don't use this setting, so I'll leave it all the way down. The microphone I'm using, the Rode NT-USB, has a headphone jack built in, so I can listen to my voice while I record through the microphone itself with no delay, which is handy. Okay, so now that we have all of our options set and our microphone level all ready to go, we can record. So once you have your screen arranged the way you want it, you select the red record button, and you'll get this on-screen prompt. Click to record the full screen, drag to record part of the screen. Okay, so what does this mean? Well, if you click anywhere on this screen, you'll be recording your entire screen. But if you click and drag, you'll get the selection window. And you can start recording by pressing this button. But you can adjust this selection window by grabbing its edge, clicking and dragging. You can also adjust the size by grabbing these little gray circles on the outside of the window, clicking and dragging to size the window. Only content within this selection window will be recorded. If you're not happy with your selection window, just hit the escape key, and that'll take you out of recording mode and back to the screen recording interface. All right, let's actually record something. So I'm going to hit the red record button again, and I'll get that prompt about the screen area. I want to record my entire screen, so I'm going to just click anywhere on the screen. And now I'm recording. And I know I'm recording because of this little stop icon way up here in the top menu bar. Here's a little tip. You want to wait until this little stop icon is fully black before you start delivering your content. When it's fully black, it means the recording is up to speed and running. If you don't wait for that icon to be fully black before you start, the beginning of your presentation may be cut off. Okay, so now we're recording. So I'm going to deliver a little bit of this example tutorial here. So one of the great features of Apple Keynote is a transition called Magic Move. But it works more than like a transition. It's really an animation technique. Here I have a slide and I have some basic shapes on here. And I have Magic Move applied to this slide to transition from this slide to the next slide. So let's just see how this works. So I'm going to go up and select play, play slideshow. Here's my slide. Now I'll hit the forward arrow key and watch what happens. Very cool. Let's get out of that by hitting escape. Okay, so I'm going to stop my little tutorial demo here. And when you're ready to stop recording, there's two ways you can do it. You can go up to this stop icon and click that. Another less conspicuous way to stop your screen recording is to use the keyboard shortcut Command Control Escape, which is what I'll do to stop this recording. Once you stop the recording, your recorded file will pop up automatically, as you can see right here, so that you can check it. I'll quickly check my recording. Hit the play button here on the QuickTime Player. And now I'm recording. And I know I'm recording because of this little stop icon way up here in the top menu bar. Here's a little tip. You want to wait until this little stop icon is fully black before you start delivering your content. When it's fully black, it means the recording is up to speed and running. If you don't wait for that icon to be fully black before you start, the beginning of your presentation may be cut off. Okay, so now we're recording. So I'm going to deliver a little bit of this example tutorial here. So one of the great features of Apple Keynote is a transition called Magic Move. But it works more than like a transition. It's really an animation technique. Here I have a slide and I have some basic shapes on here. And I have Magic Move applied to this slide to transition from this slide to the next slide. Okay, I'll stop that. It seems to be all there. Now, if you're not happy with your recording, you can trash it by going up and selecting this red close icon, the red X here. You'll get this dialogue that will give you a choice to delete your recording. And you can do that by selecting the delete button right here. You can also save your screen recording from this dialogue, and that's what export as means. You enter a name for your screen recording file here in this field. And if you select this drop-down arrow, you can find a place for your recording on your hard drive. I'm just going to hit cancel to get out of this dialogue screen. Another way to save your recording is to go up to the top menu and select File, Save, and then find a spot on your machine and then hit Save. So as you see, making a screen recording using QuickTime Player is pretty simple. If all you want to do is record your screen and your voiceover narration, which to be honest is pretty much what you're going to want to do for most of the screencast tutorials that you create. But what if you want to record your screen, your voiceover narration, and the sounds coming from your computer, sounds coming from the applications that you're demonstrating, for example? Well, unfortunately, you can't do that with QuickTime Player alone. You need an extra piece of software. Now, if you're interested in learning how to do that, to record your screen, your voiceover narration, and the sounds coming from your computer using QuickTime Player, I've got a video tutorial that explains how to do that. I'll leave a link to that tutorial in the description below. And as always, if you want to learn more about how to create engaging, informative, and educational video, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.